Okay, it's the 14th of the 3rd, 2024. So this is an introduction and summary to the video. And then the video will start after the introduction. The last date given on the video was the 17th of the 5th, 23. It's now the 15th of the 3rd, 24. So this is 10 months after the work, and I've had a bit of time to see exactly how the work's gone. I'll mention it later, but try to get the original ball joints or tie rod ends that have ball joints. Try to get the same ones. If you get a different type, it's going to throw out your wheel alignment. Okay, I have some notes here I'll go through, and I'll just explain the main difficulties and main highlights and important things in the work, and then we'll go to the actual video. Okay, so as I said, if you get a different type of ball joint than the one that's already on it, you'll put your ball joints on and your wheels won't be in line. After this sort of work, it's a good idea to get a wheel alignment anyway, but you don't want that type of thing, especially if you're relying on your car to get to work the next day. I registered this car 1 or 2 days after doing this work. I did get a wheel alignment. But at the same time, surprisingly, he said he had to put on a new set of tyres. And I thought the tyres on the car, on the video, looked pretty good. He said there was some slight cracking on the sidewall. They seemed pretty good to me. Let me know what you thought. For the tie rod adjuster, it's anti-clockwise, or this way, to bring the back of the tyre in. Okay, so here's the tie rod end. It's that bit there. Here's the adjustment arm. You turn this to wind the back of the tyre in or out. So this here has got a nut just here, and you would turn that anti-clockwise, and in so doing you would screw the thread in, so this distance would be less, and so the back of the tire would come in. With a wheel alignment, one of the most important things, if not the most important thing, believe it or not, is to make sure the steering wheel is level. So you have to make sure that the steering wheel is level. I did actually get a level and go from side to side to set this wheel level. In a second I am going to show the wheel alignment. In other words, the actual wheel alignment from the tire shop. And we can compare that to the wheel alignment I did. Basically what I've found is this, in Australia we're driving on the right hand side, so this tyre is straight, the other one is pointing out a bit, and I think they do that on purpose, although it is very similar to the wheel alignment I did. So I actually got a level, this one here, and I put it on the steering wheel to adjust it. Of course, if you get the same ball joints that's on the car already, you won't have to do a wheel alignment, because you'll make your markings on the thread and you'll put them on the way they the same as how the previous ball joints were on. Also, this is why I like to do an introduction a few months later, because all sorts of interesting, other unpredicted things show up. And one of the things I noticed is that I had a rattle in the front suspension, and I would tighten up in the engine bay, I would tighten up the nut on the top of the suspension unit, and that would stop it. However, after having installed the new ball joints, that rattle has completely disappeared. Okay, so what I'll do now is just quickly show the wheel alignment from the tyre shop. So this is the passenger side in Australia, the driver's side in the USA. So if there was any toe out, it would be on the other side in the USA, because the theory is if you let go of the steering wheel or if you start to aquaplane on water, the car will deviate, off, say, you know. So in Australia, if you're driving on the left-hand side and there's cars on the right, it'll go that way. And if you're driving in America on the right-hand side and there's cars on the left-hand side, the car will naturally deviate to the right-hand side away from the traffic. Okay, let's have a look at the wheel alignment here. So I'll try to center this over the top of the wheel. Okay, so we can see that the toe is steering out this way, away from the traffic on the right-hand side. We'll now go to the other side. Okay, on the other side, it looks like there. Okay, so that is pretty straight. That's pretty straight, if not perfect actually. I'd say that's perfectly in line with the car. Okay, as I said, I did do a wheel alignment, and I did notice that this side was different. Maybe I adjusted the toe out, I don't know, but okay, that's the introduction to the video. Okay, so I hope that when you do watch the video, which is starting soon, that it's of some help, and that I've if you do have this problem with the wheel alignment coming, then I hope that this gets you through that a bit more easily.
I don't recommend it, but it does lessen the tension of the grease inside the rubber. And when you install it by drilling, it'll come out of those relief points. So that's something I do, but I can't recommend doing that. I do pack my ball joints with more grease, and that sort of conditions the rubber, and it makes a sort of a round in the rubber instead of the rubber collapsing, and it'll perforate over time around the seam here. So that's one of my own tricks. I'm still waiting for the long-term results of that. As yet, I don't see any problems with that technique. Okay, we're going to count the number of turns. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15. So it started there. So, okay. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, ten, eleven, twelve, thirteen, fourteen, fifteen. Okay, that's interesting. That's not going in. Okay, that's all good. That just has to be turned back, and then it went back into the same point. So actually, what I might do is just going to put a little bit in here. So it releases next time if somebody else changes the ball join, or even if I do, right? Okay, I'll put the nut on there. We'll get there soon. There's the relief hole. You can see the grease coming through there. So there was just a tiny bit too much grease, but that will allow the pressure to sort of like reach equilibrium. Now, where's that hole? There it is there. Maybe a bit more. Was that too much? Okay, well, that's interesting. I can't get the cotter pin through. I can see the hole, but the cotter pin won't go through. So what we'll try is we'll try the old Kessel nut. All right, maybe, yes, the other one's much thinner. Sorry, it's not as long. So if it'll fit, we'll use this one, the old one. The one on the other side, that fitted. See. Okay, I won't bore you with that. I'll find the hole. What I used to do when I was a young boy was to find it that way, see. So it just needs to be turned a little bit more, I think. Yeah. Which way would be better?
Actually,
I think it needs to be cut a bit. It's not going to cut like the other side. The other side cut very easily. Anyway, it is what it is, so, you know, that's it. Okay, well, it's a bit out, and I may have to get a wheel alignment, but anyway, let's move on. Pretty hard to see, it's a bit dark. Okay, I'm happy. So, okay, the ball joins through. Or the tie rod end, the nut's done up, so as I can, it's done up tight, and I've got the cotter pin in, the lock nut is in. It's not exactly where it was, because we see here that might be able to see the yellow on the end there. Okay, and that's the original. So, you know, it could be a little bit out. So, in this case, might want to get a wheel alignment. Just to clean anywhere where I've touched. Go and look at the other side. So that's the old tie rod. Just get a bit of focus on that and see where the where's the split now. There it is. Okay, surprisingly, this metal bit there, that's come off. But it does look kind of similar. But this is a, you know, more robust design compared to that. All right, let's try not to drag this out too much. There's the other one. The original mark is directly underneath, but that's the other one. So safety first. I only work on a car when it's up on blocks. Well, these days, for the last 5-7 years. The jack's under there for good luck. Good luck's a very good thing to have, because this is going to damage your body if it falls on it. The wheel chocks on the back, the bricks, I find the bricks would be adequate.
okay, especially if there's bricks on the other side. These are the front wheels. I sprayed them with Dulux Gloss Black, so they're going to look better under the hubcaps than that. So, okay, I think that could be a wrap, unless I've got anything else to say to draw the video out even longer. Just got an oil change done on the Rodeo every 5,000. Okay, all right, over and out. And one problem is that the new tie rod ends seem to be of another dimension. So if we look here, we can see that the wheel is turned in that way. So using this part of the car body to line up, we can see that it's in fact turned in. Okay, so we need to do a wheel alignment just to get it to the tire shop. I have to now do a blue slip on this car, because this Holden Rodeo has a loose water pump gasket. It took 10 litres of water plus my 11 summer drink bottles, these drink bottles here, to get it home. I actually used every last drop to get it here, 85 kilometres, and that was yesterday. So you can probably see the container maybe in there with the yellow lid on it. So that's 10 litres plus 10 of those bottles. So that's now off the road. That's been my spare car for 6 months. This, as you might know, went out with a blown fuse when I was replacing the... I didn't disconnect the battery, and this lead here touched the car body and burnt the fuse out. So always disconnect your battery if you're going to put a new alternator on. But this is now working well. But I've replaced the tie rods, as you know. And but this wheel is now completely out. So I have done this side, so we can see on this side that it's quite straight when we line it up. You have to be over the middle there, and we can see that that's fairly good. Okay. So we're going to do the same on this side. I set up a piece of string, but because the wheels are wider on the front of the car than the back, you're never going to be able to run a straight edge. I've got a few pieces of wood I was going to run from the back wheel to the front wheel. I did run string, as I said, but as I say, because the front wheels are wider than the back, there's just no way to do it. So I'm going to go here. This seems to be fairly accurate, and we can see that the wheel is turned in that way. So what I'm going to do is loosen off the tie rod end, and we're going to adjust it so that this tire is flush with this piece of the front fender there. Okay, so going by my notes here, by adjusting the tie rod anti-clockwise, the back goes in. So anti-clockwise is that way, the back will go in. And clockwise, which is this way, the back of the tire will come out. Okay, so as I say, that's not too bad, all right? So we'll use this ridge here, and I'll try to demonstrate that. I don't know how it's going to go. But I'd say that that could be it there. So it does change the lens is on the far side of the camera. So if I situate it over the top there, that may be a better indication of the adjustment that I've done, possibly. Okay, so let's do the same thing. I think that's over the middle of the wheel there. Do the same thing on this side. I'll get my mat down so I don't wear holes in my pants. Take the wheel off, undo the nut, and start adjusting it. Okay, so on this side, which is the left-hand side. Okay, I think it's clockwise this way is to get the back of the wheel out. So I'll put the wheel back on, tighten up a couple of studs, and we'll start to get it straighter. Okay, it is a bit hard to judge exactly where the lens is in relation to everything. I think that's centered over the middle, so we'll just see now that that's well and truly sticking out on this side. So let's bring the back in and get it so that we can bring it to a tire place. Just like to point out that the steering wheel at this stage is straight, and it's also stopped turning with the seatbelt. So the steering wheel is straight. From a video I found, I have used this method of bringing the belt through. So there's the top member, there's the top, the bottom member. They both go on top here. Okay, they both go on top and down, and they're connected in here. Now, this just happens to be the exact length. If you pull out all stops, you will get it to go over there and click in. So this is more than just a made-up method. I'd say this is the proper way to go about it. But that's level. I also got a level. And I eyed that off to make sure it was straight. It looks like it could have gone out of alignment a little bit, unfortunately. So this is something you may have to possibly keep checking. So I'll just make sure that's right. So yeah, the other side is perfect. When I got the steering wheel perfect, the wheel alignment on the other side was perfect. We come here and we see that is still out at the back. So I think it could be anti-clockwise to bring the back of the wheel in, but we'll keep going. So I brought it back to where it was, and I'll give it four more turns the other way. Okay, I'll keep going with that. So it's definitely anti-clockwise, which is that way, for the back to go in. So I hope there wasn't too much confusion there. So this is this side, and it's anti-clockwise is back in. And if we look on the other side of the car, it's anti-clockwise is back in. Okay, anti-clockwise is back in, so it's the same. So that way is for the back in on both sides. Okay, so now to tighten up. Okay, so at this point, that's all. The lock nut is now tightened up, and put the wheel back on, and that'll be job done. When you put the wheel back on,
Don't forget to let it sit on the ground so that the wheel doesn't spin. You wouldn't want to put all that force on the drive axle. So the wheel's on the ground a bit, and now we'll start doing up the wheel nuts. Okay, I'll finish tightening that up. Okay, at this stage the car is off its blocks. Never work on a car that's not on blocks. Don't just rely on a car jack. So now if we have a look at the car, I'll center myself over the middle of the wheel. And we can see that that's far better. Okay. So now I believe I can safely and accurately get to a car alignment place. I believe this is the wrapping up of the video now, of the changing of the tie rod ends. I hope that in some way this helps. Don't forget to put the car up on blocks, get the level out, get the steering wheel straight, put the seat belt around the steering wheel, keep checking the steering wheel is straight while you're doing the tie rods. I do write down notes that I want to say. I just want to say that try to get the same ball joins as what's on there. Have a look at the trade name and just try and match them up with the new ones, because otherwise you will need a wheel alignment. It's a good idea to get a wheel alignment anyway. Yeah, so that covers it. Just try and get the same ball joints and then get your wheel alignment. Please, if you don't have the tools and experience to do this job safely, please use a mechanic. My videos are, a lot of the work is done for the first time, okay? And my videos are more for entertainment purposes only. But anyway, other than that, there's my BMX bike. I have to put brakes on that, put a longer seat post on it. The bloke before me, I think he put this these new pedals on, the wheels, and he put different handlebar grips on. These BMX bikes are quite wide, and I did I remember back in the mid 70s when I got my first BMX bike, I went in between the house and the garage and I jammed up the handlebars, and funnily enough, one of my first rides, because I've just had a 40 year break from BMX bikes, I think I jammed it up somewhere between something here. Could have been between the car and the shed or somewhere, but yeah. Just remember that the BMX bikes have wide handlebars. Yeah, so that's it for this for a while. I have to put a new water pump and timing belt on that to get it going. Hopefully I didn't overheat it too much. I don't think I did. It was pulling strong up a hill. This is now, I have to go and blue slip this, so I don't actually have a car at the moment. Yeah, so I think that's the latest and greatest. Oh, another video that's coming out is the installation of this and all the problems that went along with it. The old roller door motor stopped working. So this one went on. There's limited space in between there. It was jamming on the track. It did actually also unwind. So when you're installing a roller door,
to get the motor on that side, you have to make sure this is tightened up. On this side of the roller door, if this U-bolt comes undone, if that comes undone, the rod will unwind. Okay, so it'll go that way, it'll unwind and this will fall down. The actual roller door won't fall down, but this, it'll unwind and hit the ground. So just make sure that that's done up. You get the tension again by doing this side up. You get a big plumber's wrench, and it's you undo the U-bolt, you bring it down, and then you do it up. You reposition your plumber's wrench, you undo it, you bring it down, and then you do it up to lock it in place, and you keep on going like that until you get full tension. And I found that winding it up the most, I got my tension. So this video will be coming out soon. Okay, so you can see that's properly balanced. It's in the middle there. If it wasn't balanced, it would either go down or up, but that's good. I just have to adjust the track. There may be a little bit of jamming. Okay. So I've just got to finish off, and I've got to calibrate the opener with the motor. Okay, so that's it. Yes, please like and subscribe. Okay, it's now the 14th of the 3rd, 2023. So that's about 10 months after the work was done. I did get the Camry registered in the next few days after the video was made. It did require new tyres. The tyre shop said that the tyres that were on it during the video had a little bit of cracking in the sidewall. I thought they looked okay. Another thing, I did get a wheel alignment, but that seemed similar to the wheel alignment I did. This side is turned out a bit and the other side is straight. This is a right-hand side car, steering wheel car, so that seems good. Okay, I'll show the wheel alignment that the tyre shop did. The steering wheel is straight. So this is the right-hand side in Australia. So we can see that tyre is tracking straight, so that looks good. And now we're at the other side. Okay, and this wheel is pointing that way. In Australia, the traffic is on the right-hand side, and so the car would naturally steer that way. If aquaplaning, or if you took your hand off the wheel for, 4 or 5 seconds. Okay, so that seems logical. I hope you've enjoyed the video. Please like and subscribe.